they have to do a night navigation exercise. Now Dartmoor is famous for being difficult to navigate in by daylight because of the barren, featureless terrain. But tonight it'll be even more difficult. They're going to have to pay really careful attention to their compass bearings and the paces they're taking. Added to that, they've got to cross one of the most remote parts of the moor and navigate around deep bogs. The reason students are going to have to navigate at night is because that's what they'd have to do in a combat survival situation. Lie low during the day and move at night under the cover of darkness. Teams are just about to set off on their night navigation exercise. Now, navigation is a critical skill of survival. Many survival situations start because people can't navigate properly. They're not being tested here. It's just an opportunity to refresh their abilities and to remind them of the importance of this skill. It's going to be conducted at night because in a wartime situation, movement by night is still the soldier's friend, despite all of the advances in modern night viewing technology. We used an image intensifier to film the exercise. If you haven't got a compass, on a clear night you can use the stars to point you in the right direction. This constellation behind me here is called the Plough, the Great Bear or the Big Dipper. That would be the handle of the dipper, and that's the bucket end, if you like. Now, if you take these two end stars here, and you join them up and keep going up, that star there, the first bright one you come to is Polaris. And if you're facing that, you're facing true north. So that's north, that's south of me, that's west, and that's east. As each of the groups come to the end of their 20-kilometre hike, news is suddenly sprung on them that the exercise has been extended for an undisclosed period of time. Up to this point, they were under the impression that they would be returning to base for a hot bath and a trip down to the local curry house. Not now.
Sam. Using all your equipment, move into the forest, and as individuals, address the priorities of survival, protection, location, water and food.
By now the students have spent over a week roughing it on the moors, and for some of them the strain is beginning to show.
After walking sort of across Dartmoor and a day up and a no sleep last night really because of the cold, I can't say I really enjoy all that. I'd prefer to be at home, let's put it that way, watching telly or something, or in bed with a wife. But wouldn't we all?
This is when the course steps up a gear. The students are now being tested on their resolve to continue with essential tasks, however exhausted and emotionally drained they might be feeling. How are you feeling?
Pretty run down, actually.
And how do you notice that? What sorts of things are different for you now?
Well, it's time-wise, really. It's more a matter of, you know, you get up and you do maybe 5 minutes work, and then I'm finding myself getting really dehydrated at the moment, so 5 minutes, take some water on, do a bit more, rest again.
Early the following morning, and you can really begin to see the effects of hunger, fatigue and dehydration. Morale seems generally low and their work is slow and laboured.
I want to go home now. And if I failed, sod it. All I'm thinking about is a Mexican tonight.
Easy to see how people can lose the will to go on. Well, because it's just we've been at it non-stop for what, 24 hours more, constantly doing stuff and no end in sight. Just get tired with it. Just absolutely knackered really, chin strapped. So it just takes a long time to do something that would usually take 4 or 5 minutes, takes half an hour. So it gets a bit frustrating as well, saps your strength and your morale.
The odds are they'll never have to do any of this for real. But as with all things in the military, training has to be for every eventuality. Up until now, the course has been conducted in peacetime circumstances. But from this point forward, the teams are on the ground in enemy territory, being pursued by a hunter force whose sole intent is their capture. Now they have to meet all of their basic needs, protection, location, water and food, whilst also employing classified techniques to enable their safe extraction by friendly forces. Over 3 days and nights, this hunter force will use a whole range of military hardware to try and catch the survival course members hiding out on Dartmoor. Because the RAF's tactics for enemy evasion are classified, we cannot disclose specific details of this exercise. But the value to the RAF course members of enduring a combat survival situation, the experience of being hunted day and night, cannot be underestimated. The students seen here filming themselves have been on the run for 2 days. Remained undetected, their sole objective now is to be rescued by Allied forces. Using special techniques which we cannot show, they managed to contact friendly forces, in this case an RAF helicopter crew, and arrange a rendezvous point for rescue. By the time the students were rescued from Dartmoor, only two out of the group of 20 course members had been caught by the hunter force. Having had the chance to practice escape and evasion, they now have a more realistic understanding of the real problems they would face behind enemy lines. Worst case scenario any of these military personnel can face is the prospect of being shot down behind enemy lines. Hopefully, the training they've received will enable them to return safely to their friends and families. To my mind, it doesn't matter though whether you're a soldier or a hiker. You can load yourself down with all the best equipment in the world, but the chances are when you need it most, it simply isn't going to be there. That's when survival training really comes into its own. There's an old saying, knowledge is the key to survival. And the real beauty of that is that it doesn't weigh anything.
Next week, mountain survival.